Hello friends, this is a video presentation, and the objective of this video is to draw quadratic equation using graphic calculator and finding critical points. Though the graphic calculator calculates, draws and also calculates or finds us the critical points, it's always good to do it by hand and then check on the graphic calculator. So I have done the working. So the x-intercept is when y is equal to 0. So I've set this y is equal to 0 and then factorized. So hopefully you should know how to factorize the simple quadratic. X take away 3 times x take away 4. The reason being negative 3 times negative 4 gives you 12, and negative 3 plus negative 4 gives you negative 7. So if we set this equal to 0, we can say x is equal to 3. So we can say one of the x-intercept is 3, 0. On the graphic calculator, this is also called root. Okay, now when we set this is equal to 0, that's what I've done here. We can say we'll find, we can say that x should be 4, because 4 minus 4 is 0. So this is your second x-intercept, or the root on the graphic calculator. So in the same way, we can find the y-intercept. The argument is same. Y-intercept is when x is equal to 0. So we can set x is equal to 0. We already know y is equal to this and this are equivalent. So in place, instead of writing, you can write y as this. So that's what I've done. So I have put the value of x as 0 in this form, which is 0 minus 3 times 0 minus 4, which is negative 3 times negative 4, which is 12. So this is your y-intercept, which is 0, 12, which will confirm. Now this is vertex or turning point, or minimum on the graphic calculator is always halfway between the x-intercept. And we know in this case the intercepts are 3 and 4. So to find halfway between 3 and 4, what I did was added them up. So 3 plus 4 is 7, divided by 2 is 3.5. So the x value of the vertex, which I write as xv, is 3.5. And to find the y value of the vertex, I did the same thing as I did for y-intercept. I put 3.5 in place of x. So as I went 0, take away 3, I went 3.5, take away 3, 3.5, take away 4, which is negative 0.25. So the vertex or turning point or minimum here is 3.5, 0.25. So let us see how to draw that and check this on the calculator. So here we go. So let me do it for you. So you type in x squared minus 7x plus 12. And then always check your settings or your scale by pressing Shift F3, which will give you the scale. So you can see the scale that I have taken for x is, x minimum is negative 3 to 7. You can take whatever scale that is necessary. So this is a necessary. This, I think, is appropriate in the situation. So the scale of 1, don't worry about the dot. For the y minimum, I've taken negative 3, and the y maximum, you can see, I've taken 15. The reason being, I know that the y-intercept is 12, so I have to have 15, and I've taken a scale of 5. Sorry, so you can exit from here, and then draw it. Here's your quadratic equation. So these are the two roots, okay, or x-intercept. This halfway, or halfway, this is the vertex or the minimum, and this is the y-intercept. So let us check it. So you press F5, and to find the root, which is the x-intercept, this is the root or x-intercept are the same. Press F1, so that this is the first root, 3, 0, okay, and if you press this, this cursor will move to the next root. So this is the next root, which is 4, 0. sorry. So now to find the y-intercept, you go gsol y-intercept. There we go. The y-intercept is 0, 12. Okay. And to find the minimum, solve vertex, gsol, you press F3, which is 3.5, 0.25. I think I did one mistake. So let me go back. So this should have been 0, 12. That's right. Okay, so let us check. Y-intercept 0, 12. That's right. So we have checked the x-intercept, the y-intercept, and the vertex. Thank you very much.